अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास, दिस इज़ वीक 3 पीसी ज्योग्राफी एंड टुडे वी विल स्टडी ग्रोथ ऑफ गिलगित। ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर एनालाइज द फैक्टर्स फॉर ग्रोथ ऑफ गिलगित, रीड द मैप्स, आइडेंटिफाई फिजिकल एंड ह्यूमन फैक्टर्स एंड आइडेंटिफाई एंड एक्सप्लेन रीजंस फॉर इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी ऑफ द एरिया। फिजिकल फैक्टर्स आर इट्स माउंटेनस एरिया एंड इट्स क्लोज टू कराकोरम रेंज, the land route Khunjerab pass is present which is connecting China with Pakistan. It is the route between the two mountains. Climate is cold and pleasant. Rainfall is there in summers as monsoon rainfall, then snowfall in winters. River Gilgit is there. There are lakes and valleys and minerals and natural vegetation is found there. For the map, see the key. There is Khunjerab Pass, which is connecting China with Pakistan. Karakoram Highway starts from there. You can see Karakoram Highway along with Hunza River. Then at the eastern side, you can see Karakoram Range. When it moves northwards, southwards, you can see the confluence of River Gilgit and Hunza. And after crossing that, you can see Gilgit over here. There are human factors for the growth as Karakoram Highway is connecting China with Pakistan and Pakistan northern areas with other areas in the south. Then on River Sawat, we can see a bridge, so it is a bridging point. Trade is also practiced over there because of the Chinese goods and the local goods as well. Cottage industry of making gemstones and handicrafts, and plus fruit farming is done, and fruits are sold in the form of dry fruits as well. The local scenic beauty is attracting tourists over there, so it is another economic activity over here. Here you can see the map. It's River Gilgit and there is a bridge. After crossing the bridge towards the north, we can see the Gilgit Bazaar. Stage 1, 2 and 3 are shown over there. On stage 1, there is a little growth just across the river. Then the roads are just moving towards the parallel or to the River Gilgit. And there is growth on east and west sides of the road. Then the third stage is the hospital road and airport road. Because of the more traffic and tourism and commuting of the people in these area, bazaars are also growing over there. Here we have jotted down all the points. You can see these. In this lesson, we have done different physical features like passes, mountains and valleys. But in previous lessons, we have talked about plains and coastal areas. Physical features like mountains and rivers sometimes create hindrances for the growth of settlements, and sometimes they encourage the settlement or economic activity. For example, pleasant climate and scenic beauty attract tourists, which can generate economic activity over there, but at the same time it is difficult to construct roads because of the topography of the area. And to make such areas accessible, human efforts change the whole scenario by using the capital and planning and technology and manpower. So we can change the rugged landscape into better human activity and economic activity. Construction of roads always lead to the development of the area, and Gilgit has a potential to grow further in its tourism and trade. This is day 2 and we will study growth of Mari. Objectives are analyze the factors for growth of Mari, read the map for location, read graph to explain the trends of population growth, and identify the problem associated with the growth of the city. Physical factors are: it is mountainous areas at the foothills of Himalayas, it's cold and pleasant climate, waterfalls, streams are there, natural vegetation is there of conifer forest, rainfall is received both western depression and monsoon, western depression in winters and monsoon summer rainfall. Snowfall is there in winters. Minerals are also found over there. Here you can see the location. Murree is close to Islamabad, and it's between Abbottabad and Islamabad. Abbottabad in the north and Islamabad is in the south. Human factors are that this was the first hill station of the area, because when British arrived over there, they wanted a settlement which is a better climate, because hot climate was not bearable for them. Soon after partition, immigrants from Kashmir came over there. Later on, it developed as a tourist point. Tourism developed over there. Infrastructure was already there, and it further grew. Small scale and cottage industry grew, and trade flourished because of the tourist activities. And transportation and communication facilities are there because it's closer to Islamabad, which is the capital city of Pakistan. And in the beginning, lot of embassies established over there. Here you can see the growth of Murree. In the beginning, it's a very slow growth rate in from 1881 to 1941, and the changes are thought to be due to the water shortage and epidemics. Later on, immigrants came, and you can see sharp increase in this time period from 41 to 1961. Murree has the easy access to the people of the plains, the local tourists, so they move in summer vacations over there. Hotels are not that much expensive. Infrastructure is there. It has led to the unplanned growth of housing and hotels. They are just like mushroom growth over there of small hotels. So there is, you can see, traffic chaos and destruction of natural vegetation. There is a lack of adequate garbage and sewage disposal system. This is day 3, and today we are going to study growth of Gwadar. Objectives are: analyze the factors for growth of Gwadar, read the map for location, then we are going to explore Gwadar's potential as seaport and CPAC, explain the geographical importance of Gwadar. Physical factors include that it's coastal area, climate is moderate, it's near deep sea, and it has land and sea links. Like, it has land routes with Central Asian Republics through Afghanistan, and through Punjab Pass links with China. Human factors are that fishing is practiced over there, mostly subsistence fishing because it's not much developed. It is a small port and trade on a limited scale is being practiced over there. Infrastructure is developing for CPAC and it has links with landlocked Central Asian states, so which is going to help after development of CPAC. And Pakistan, China-Pakistan economic corridor is being developed there. It can be shown through flow chart as well that landlocked Central Asian states through Afghanistan, they are going to be linked with Gwadar, and in the eastern side through Khunjerab Pass and through KKH, Karakoram Highway from China, it can linked with Gwadar, which can be a short distance corridor for them for trade activity. Here you can see the map. Shanghai and Kashgar can be seen over here. Shanghai is in the eastern and Kashgar is in the western part of China. Shanghai is the most developed port, but if through Shanghai, China has to take a long route to reach Africa and Europe for trading purposes. Kashgar till Gwadar, there is a shorter route and it can save time and transportation cost of 10,000 miles. Here are some other points. China wants to import, China imports oil from Middle East. So if it takes that long sea route, it is going to cost a lot to China. But if a pipeline from Gwadar to Kashgar is made, it is going to reduce the cost and time. China is going to be benefited a lot by Gwadar Chinese transit trade. So in return, China is going to do some development in Pakistan, like widening of Karakoram Highway, improvement in rail link from Peshawar to Karachi, then construction of Gwadar port and construction of world's largest solar park in Cholistan to feed electricity to the national grid.